What's going on, guys? Tessin here. Welcome to Minecraft. Today we'll show you how to make a secret door with sticky pistons in this game. So let's get started. So basically, having a secret door is very useful just in case you don't trust your friends and feel that they will sneak behind your back and steal your stuff, so you could have your own secret room with a secret door and secret way to open it and hide in it all the valuable stuff that you don't want to be taken from you, like the diamond and stuff like that. So yeah, you know, in real life, when pirates actually hide their treasure so that no one could find it, hide their treasure in islands and stuff, you'll do the same exact thing, but you will hide your treasure in secret rooms, and these secret rooms will have secret doors. So yeah, you'll basically be like a pirate in this game, just a different version. Anyways, yeah, without further ado, let's get right into showing you how to make a secret door with sticky pistons in this game. So yeah, let's get right to it. Alright, first of all, let me look for a suitable location to make the secret door. By the way, the secret door could be anywhere. It could be into a mountain, or it could be at your house. Anywhere you could make the secret room and then cover everything. It's so simple. But so that I would show you exactly what you need to do in both sides of the wall, I'm gonna make it out in the open like that. I'm gonna make an imaginary wall. I'm gonna show you exactly what you need to do in both sides. But yeah, keep in mind that you can basically do that anywhere, in a mountain, in your house, whatever. If there is a space in both sides, you can simply do it just fine. Like, you can dig inside the mountain and actually make it possible. So even if there is no space, you can dig the space. So yeah, basically you can make your secret room anywhere in the world. Anyways, let's get started into building the imaginary wall. So I'm gonna use stone. Yeah, there we go. I'm gonna make the wall like four blocks high. So yeah, let's just make it three and then make the fourth one. What the hell happened? Oh yeah, the freaking stupid sunflower. The sunflower actually cannot be destroyed magically when you build. That's a fun fact. Okay, I think that this is long enough. Now let's make an additional fourth block right here, and then we'll be good to go. Okay, there we go. Now let's make the opening. I freaking hate these sunflowers. Why did I choose a place with a bunch of sunflowers? Why the hell did I choose a place like that, sheep? Anyways, let's make the opening of the door, the secret door that we're going to open and close, and let's remove this freaking sunflower. There we go. And remove this sunflower as well. God damn it. Anyways, let's get myself a sticky piston, and we're gonna place the sticky piston like that and other ones above it like that. What the fuck, sheep? Where's the sword? There, that's what you get, and that's what you get as well. Anyways, the next thing you need to do is to place a stone right here, and then place a piston right here facing this way, and a piston right here. Then place stone in the middle like that, and place stone right here. Then you're gonna need some redstone. There you go. You're gonna need some redstone, and also gonna need a repeater, and you're gonna need a comparator. Now what you want to do is to place two redstone right here. Then you're gonna need to place a repeater right here. Open up the repeater, then continue the blocks right here and make a ladder right here, or stairs right here. Remove the freaking sunflowers, and then continue the redstones. Okay, hold on, just open it once. That's more than enough. And then continue with the redstones right here, and then place one right here. Now that's the first method of opening it. By the way, I'm gonna show you three different methods to open the secret door. I'm gonna show you the first method right now. So basically, the first method requires you to continue the redstone all the way right here. There we go. And then go to the other side of the wall, and then place a stone right here and stone right here, and then place it right here, and that's it. The first method is done. Now you need to remember exactly where that stone is and place a bunch of stones right next to it. So remember the position of this the stone. It's actually the third one from the left. Now get yourself a bunch of redstone torches. So yeah, redstone torch, there we go. And then place a bunch of redstone torches. Now as you can see, the door is closed. Now continue the redstone torches all the way down here. There we go. Maybe even place regular torches up there. So yeah, regular torches up there. Hold on, let's place it right there. There we go. And continue. And that's basically the first method of opening the secret door. Now this looks like a decoration that you could place in your house or whatever. Just remember exactly which torch opens the door, which is the third one from the left, the redstone one. Third one from the left opens the door. There we go. And if you want to close it, simply return the torch right there. So that's the first method. No one's gonna ever suspect that this is not a simple decoration. Just remember, the third torch from the left is the one that opens the secret door, and you can go in the middle. Obviously, you can close all this up, but I'm not gonna do it now because I'm gonna show you two different methods of opening it, so I need it open. But you can close all this up. I'm gonna show you in the end. You can close all this up and then make your secret room right here. For example, this is gonna be a mini hall into your room. So yeah, that's the first method of opening it. If you place this right like that, the door is closed, and that's a simple decoration right there. If you remove that, remember exactly which one it is. If you remove that, it will open the secret room for you, and that's the first method of opening and closing the secret door. Now let me remove all that, and then I'm gonna show you the second method of removing of opening and closing the secret door. Now basically, the second method requires you to go to the other side of the wall. Just remove all these, you don't need this now, and close up this place. There we go. Now I'm gonna do it a little bit further from the stairs. So what you wanna do is to use a comparator and place it while your back needs to be facing the wall, and place it like that. There we go. And that's it. It needs to be like these two ears right there are facing the wall. They're gonna need to place two redstones right here. There we go. They're gonna need to get yourself a repeater and face yourself like that with the redstone and place the repeater like that. There we go. And open it up a little bit and then continue with the redstone like here, like that, and then go with the redstone all the way right here and go with it all the way right here. And there we go. Now we're gonna need to make an opening right here so that you know exactly where the redstone is. So this is the one. It's going to be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, it's gonna be hard to count that, but yeah, it's gonna be right here. Just remember that. We're gonna need something called cauldron right there. There we go. Get yourself cauldron and place it right here. Now close this part right here. There we go. Now get yourself a water bucket, which is this one. There we go. And fill the water bucket. Now you will notice that the door has closed. Now how to open the secret door with the water cauldron? All you gotta do is to get yourself a bottle and use the bottle to get the water once and twice, and the door will be opened in the second time and you can go through it to the secret room. And if you fill the cauldron again, the door will be closed. So that's basically how it's gonna work. Two times with the bottle is going to open it, and the water bottle itself is gonna close it. If you're in survival, you can use the two water bottles that you actually filled so that you will refill it. It will work just fine. So fill two empty glass bottles to open the door, and with these two glass bottles that you have filled in the survival, you can simply fill the cauldron again to close the door. And that's the second way to open and close the secret door without anyone suspecting anything. You can simply place that water cauldron in your house. No one will suspect it. Like I said, it will be a simple decoration. Another way to open and close the secret door is going to be in the exact same location of the water cauldron, right in front of the comparator. By the way, this is a little piece of information that I'm gonna give you. The comparator, when it's turned on, it gives very low power into the redstone, but the repeater maximizes it. So the repeater is basically a magical item in this game. It maximizes the power in a very ridiculous way. So yeah, that might be a useful information that you could use in a lot of your redstone builds. Anyways, in the exact location of the water cauldron, right in front of the comparator, you need to place a furnace. If you notice, the door is opened once more. Now how to close it? You will need to get yourself a bunch of coal like these. There we go. Now let me show you something in that furnace. So if you place, for an example, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, okay, 12, 13, if you place 13 coals right here, the door is still open. But if you place a number 14 coal, the door is closed. So that's basically how you do the match right here with this exact same redstone arrangement that I have, and only two redstones in front of the comparator. By the way, if it's not two, it will be different. So just make exactly what I'm doing right here. Two redstones in front of the comparator, and after that a repeater that maximizes the power magically. If you do this exact same thing I'm doing right there and two redstone in front of the comparator, then it will need exactly 14 coals in order for it to be kept closed. If you want to open the door, you can simply take the 14 coals and then enter your secret room and secret door and do whatever it is that you want to do here. And if you want to leave and close it again, just keep the 14 coals together, separated from the other coals, place the 14 coals like that, and that's it. The door is closed. No one will ever suspect it. Like, this is just a regular furnace in your house. What the hell is there to suspect? So basically, I've shown you three methods to open and close the secret door. One with the furnace, one with the water cauldron, and one with the redstone torch. Now the last thing I'm gonna show you is to how to make it more suitable, because as you can see, there is a lot of redstone bullshit around. So how to make it more suitable is by simply using the stone to cover up all these things right there. There we go. And you can use the stone to cover it up as well. There we go. Make yourself a mini hallway right here until all the redstones are done. Like, we're done with all the redstones, no more redstones. And then you can simply start making your room. What the hell is, oh, of course, the sunflower freaking right there. Okay, you can start making your room right here. After that mini hallway, you can start making the room all over the place. So yeah, just you need to make the mini hallway so that it will surpass all this redstone stuff, that all this redstone mess that we did right there. But after that redstone mess, you can simply go and start making your room right here. So you will have to make a mini hall to surpass the redstone mess, and it will work the same exact way after you made that hole. Like, for example, if you place the 14 coal right there, it will be closed, and if you place remove the 14 coals, it will be open just fine. So yeah, the hole will not affect anything. It will just simply cover up the redstone mess that you did just now, and you can simply control if it's closed and opened with whatever method that you use for opening and closing. The water cauldron will also work just fine with the hole, and the redstone torches will work just fine with the hole. So everything will work just fine with the hole, and simply walk through the hole and go into your secret room and hide whatever it is that you need to be hidden. Anyways, yeah, that's all about how to make a secret room in this game. Like I said, the secret room could be very useful in a lot of ways, like hiding it from your friends, hiding stuff from your friends online if you don't trust them, which you shouldn't, by the way. They will probably steal whatever they can from you. You can also do it simply so that you will feel like you're an important person, like Batman, for an example. Batman, who has his own bat cave so that he will do his own shady stuff without anyone finding out what's going on in there. You know, you can do all your criminal stuff inside. I'm saying Batman is not a criminal. Why did I say that? No, yeah, Batman is not a criminal. Anyways, yeah, doing all your secret stuff inside. That's what I'm trying to say. Anyways, yeah, that's all about how to make a secret door with sticky pistons in this game. And yeah, that's all. Thanks for watching, guys. Later. Bye.